If you're running your site on WordPress and you're wondering whether you should switch to Webflow or not, then you are in the right place. This video should help you understand what it takes to make that switch, to migrate from WordPress to Webflow. Get ready, grab your cup of coffee, and let's get into it. And just an early heads up, this is not a step-by-step tutorial. The sole purpose here is to give a strategic overview, what's involved in migrating, what to think about before making the move, and how Webflow empowers teams to build and manage websites visually. So, whether you're designing, marketing, procrastinating on YouTube, or leading web projects at your organization, you are in the right place. So, we'll do this in 5 chapters. We'll start by talking about why consider the change from WordPress to Webflow. Then, we'll talk through the different types of audits. We'll get into analyzing your WordPress site before you change over. Then we'll dig into parts of the migration itself. And finally, we'll go over publishing and managing your site in Webflow. Let's start with the why. Why consider the change? Moving to Webflow is all about simplifying your stack and empowering your team. And quite frankly, one of the biggest reasons teams consider moving off WordPress? Maintenance overload. In WordPress, you're often juggling plugin updates, core updates, theme compatibility, server requirements, and constantly watching for anything that might break your site or slow it down. Security risks, performance hits, plugin conflicts, they're all part of the whole site managing experience. Webflow simplifies that. Hosting, CMS, SEO, performance, even localization, it's all built in. That means no plugin pain, no theme surprise updates, and no wondering if your server has enough RAM or CPU to handle your next traffic spike. In addition to that, there's the Webflow Marketplace, where you can find apps that can help integrate other parts of your tech stack into your site. Webflow empowers you to create unique, highly customized websites without being boxed in by rigid themes, plugin dependencies, or restrictive CMS structures. That level of flexibility is especially valuable for enterprise teams that want to stand out, build rich digital experiences, and avoid the constraints that often come with traditional or even headless CMS platforms. And more importantly, this means faster time to market, fewer dependencies, and more control for designers and marketers to ship changes without waiting on development. And long term, it tends to translate to better return on investment, less maintenance overhead, and more scalable workflows, which is why more and more teams are making the switch. Okay, that's a high-level overview on why to consider the change. Let's talk about the need for different types of audits. Before shutting down your site and jumping into Webflow, it's extremely important to audit your existing WordPress site. By doing that, it gives you a clear roadmap for the migration process. It can be helpful to split the audit into 3 categories: functionality, content structure, and design. Let's start with the functionality. Start by making a list of your key plugins and features. What are they doing, and why are they important for your business? Things like forms, SEO tools, APIs, or multilingual content. Then compare those to what Webflow offers natively. You may find you can simplify or even replace entire plugin stacks with built-in features in Webflow. For your content structure, start by identifying what's static, like your homepage or about page, and what's dynamic, like blog posts or team bios. Static content is great for when you want maximum flexibility with your designs and creativity. CMS content is best for when you have very templated content or content that needs to appear in a list. You'll also want to map your schema. Make sure your existing post types and fields map to your new Webflow CMS collections. Recreate your schema in a way that works natively in Webflow. And strongly consider exporting your content that you can then import to Webflow with a CSV, especially if you're dealing with custom post types. And lastly, for your design, ask yourself and your team a few questions. Are you planning a redesign? Or rebuilding the current site as is? Does everything have to look like liquid glass now? This affects how you build, whether you're starting from scratch, using a template, or working with Webflow experts. Whatever route you go, it's an opportunity to clean up and even rethink your entire design structure to make the best use of the features in Webflow. And honestly, before making any kind of switch, you should create a backup of everything. All right, when you've done your audit, it's time to dig into the details. Who's working on your site and how it's actually performing. First, it's important to test your site performance. Run speed tests, check your sitemap and URL structure. These details help inform redirects and SEO planning later. Then, you'll want to understand who is actually contributing to your site, who's doing what and what roles do you need. Designers, marketers, developers, content editors. In Webflow, roles can be customized. A marketer can update pages without risking layout changes. A lead designer can have full creative control, while a junior designer can help with design but can only publish to the staging domain. Understanding these roles early helps you build a structure that fits your team. Once you're done analyzing, you're ready to move or migrate your site. Here's what that typically involves. Map core functionality. Rebuild your design system. Configure your CMS. And review your SEO and set up redirects. Let's dig into the first one. It's crucial to know what your new site actually needs. That might include things like analytics, forms, SEO tools, or localization. In Webflow, many of these can be configured natively or integrated through third-party apps or code snippets. You need to make sure you're successfully transferring over the tools and the setup from your old site. Then, once you've defined that, it's worth rebuilding your design system in Webflow using classes, variables, components, page templates, and even shared libraries. This helps maintain consistency and makes future updates easier, especially for larger teams or evolving brands. Configure your CMS. Taking the content audit you created earlier, use Webflow collections to structure dynamic content, like blog posts, case studies, or portfolios. Plan carefully here, especially if you're importing data or replicating a complex CMS setup. And finally, make sure your SEO and redirects are done correctly. Make sure your meta tags, alt text, and open graph data are all in place. Webflow gives you tools to manage all of this. And also, don't forget 301 redirects, so existing links to your site keep working post-launch. Keep in mind, this will vary depending on the size of your site and the amount of content, plugins, and considerations you need to make. That's a high-level take on the migration process. Let's look at our last step, publish and manage in Webflow. Once your site is rebuilt and tested, you're ready to launch. It can be helpful to go through a pre-launch checklist, test responsiveness, double-check accessibility, and review your SEO settings. Once that's done, all you have to do is connect your custom domain, hit publish, and preview everything live. Once we're live, updates are instant. No FTP, no developer handoffs, no waiting. Whether it's a quick text change or a full section redesign, you can make edits directly on the canvas and publish with a click. That's it. Let's recap this real quick. We talked about why teams are considering the switch from WordPress to Webflow. We covered how to audit your current setup from plugins to content to design. Then we looked at analyzing your site and your contributors to understand who's doing what. After that, we broke down the migration process from functionality and content to SEO and design systems. And finally, we walked through what it looks like to publish, manage, and grow your site in Webflow post-launch. Switching from WordPress to Webflow isn't a small task, easier said than done. But once it is done, you unlock a faster, cleaner, more collaborative way to build for the web. And you are empowering your team to move faster, reduce costs, and most importantly, drive better results for your business. And I know that sounded like a marketing pitch, but the truth is we've seen it work. Again, this is just a high-level overview of what you need to look into when you're considering moving your site from WordPress to Webflow. We'll be making more videos about this whole process in the near future, but let us know in the comments if there are any specific things about WordPress to Webflow you'll want us to cover. But you can always email me at greemer@webflow.com. That's an introduction on what to consider when migrating from WordPress to Webflow.